Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter, electrostatic potential and capacitance. In the last chapter we dealt with electric field, electric force, electric dipole moment. All these quantities are vector quantities. In this chapter, that is electrostatic potential and capacitance, we are going to deal with electrostatic potential energy, electrostatic potential difference, etc. These quantities are scalar quantities. Now, let us see what is electric potential. Electric potential at any point means work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. For example, imagine there is a charge Q. I want to find the potential at one particular point, say for example A. So how I would find the potential? What I have to do is, how much is the work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to the point A? So suppose I take a small charge Q and this point is at infinity. Now, from infinity, I am bringing that point charge to A. That work done is actually electric potential. So, we can write electric potential V is equal to work by charge. So, V is equal to W by Q. SI unit of electric potential is volt and the potential is a scalar quantity. SI unit is volt and the potential is a scalar quantity. Now, even though we say electric potential is a scalar quantity, potential due to a positive charge is taken as positive and potential due to a negative charge is taken as negative. So here, since potential is a scalar quantity, if we find the total potential, we only have to add the potentials or subtract the potentials. We don't have to consider the vector algebra. That means we don't have to do any vector consideration in this entire chapter. Now let us see what is electric potential difference. Electric potential difference between any two points is the work done in bringing a unit positive charge from one point to another. Just remember the previous definition I taught, electric potential. Electric potential means work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to any point. Electric potential difference means work done to bring a unit positive charge from one point to another. It is not from infinity, it is bringing the charge from one point to another. Therefore, we can write like this. Potential difference VBA. VBA means potential at B minus potential at A. VB minus VA. That is equal to WAB by Q. So VBA equal to WAB by Q. So please note this consideration, because to find the potential difference between two points B and A, we have to consider work done to bring a unit positive charge from A to B, not from B to A. You have to take the work from A to B. So WAB by Q. And SI unit is again volt. So SI unit of potential and SI unit of potential difference is volt. Now, let us see how to derive an expression for the electric potential due to a point charge. So, expression for the electric potential due to a point charge. Imagine a charge Q. I want to find the potential at any point O, which is at a distance R from O. Which is at a distance R from Q. So, as per definition, it is the work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to the point O. So, what I first do is, I consider two points here, A and B, which is at a distance of dx. A and B, which is at a distance of dx. Now, distance from the charge Q to the point A is considered as x. Now, imagine a unit positive charge at Q. Imagine a unit positive charge Q at the point A. Then, first we are going to find the electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion between the charge capital Q and the charge small q. So, electrostatic force of attraction can be given by the equation. It may not be attraction always, it can be attraction or repulsion. In this case, these two are positive charge, so there will be force of repulsion. If one charge is positive and another charge is negative, there will be force of attraction. Whatever it may be, the equation is F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 capital Q small q by x square. That is the electrostatic force. Now, we have to find the small work done to bring this charge small q from A to B. In the figure it is marked A to B, the distance is dx. So, we are moving this charge small q from A to B, that is against the electrostatic force of repulsion. Therefore, the equation will be dw is equal to vector f dot dx, which is f dx cos theta. Here theta is 180 degree because we are moving the charge small letter q against the force of repulsion. That is why I take cos 180, and cos 180 is minus 1, so the equation is minus f into dx. Now, if I find the small work like this, what is the total work? Total work done to move the charge, small letter q, from infinity to the point O. From infinity to the point O. So, to find the total work, I have to use integration. The lower limit is infinity and the upper limit is point O. Point O means the distance is marked as R. So, I write infinity to R. So, integrating infinity to R minus f dx. That is integrating infinity to R minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 capital Q small q by x square into dx. Now, other than x square, every other quantities are constant. So, I take all the constants outside and only 1 by x square is taken inside. And 1 by x square can be written as x raised to minus 2. Therefore, W is equal to minus qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 x raised to minus 2 dx within the integral. And to integrate, we use the equation integral x raised to n dx is equal to x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. We are using this equation for integration. Therefore, W is equal to minus capital Q small q by 4 pi epsilon 0 x raised to minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1 within the limit infinity to R. This can be written as minus q q by 4 pi epsilon 0 x raised to minus 1 by minus 1. Now, you can see minus 1 here. When I take that outside, minus and this minus. This minus 1 and this minus sign. Both the minus will be cancelled. And x raised to minus 1 can be written as 1 by x. Therefore, equation will be qq by 4 pi epsilon 0. 1 by x within the limit infinity to R. Now the next step is upper limit minus lower limit. That means in this variable x, substitute the upper limit minus lower limit. So you will get 1 by R minus 1 by infinity. And since 1 by infinity is equal to 0, we can write this equation as W is equal to q small q by 4 pi epsilon 0 1 by R. Now we studied electric potential. Electric potential is V, which means W by Q. So, QQ by 4 pi epsilon 0 R into Q. So small q get cancelled, and the final answer is V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 capital Q by R. So V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 capital Q by R. From this expression, it is clearly understood that electric potential due to a point charge is inversely proportional to R. In the last class, last chapter, we studied electric field equation, and the equation for electric field was, electric field is denoted by E. So equation for electric field due to a point charge, we studied this as 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r square. So from here, electric field proportional to 1 by r square. So when we compare both equations, it is clear that V proportional to 1 by R, whereas E proportional to 1 by R square. So if I draw the graph between electric field and electric potential in the same axis with distance R, I will get the graph like this. E or V will be taken in the y-axis and R is taken in the x-axis, and you can see V proportional to 1 by R, E proportional to 1 by R square. So the graph will be like this. The green color graph is for V, which V proportional to 1 by R, and the blue color graph is for E, E proportional to 1 by R square. So the graph of electric field is having more slope than the graph of potential. I hope you have understood this derivation. Thank you.